Hi student, and welcome to you to a new section. Today we will discuss about the measurement system, which is in the chapter 2. But here we will discuss the mass measurement, how you will measure mass. So you all know in our day-to-day life, we always face with the name, or we always hear the name like mass. If you want to buy something, and if you go to the market, then if you want to buy some oranges, yeah, some apple, then you say that give me 1 kilo apple, yeah, 2 kilo oranges. So mass measurement became an important part in our life. So today we will discuss about that mass measurement, how we will do the measurement of the mass. So first of all, I will tell you what does it mean. I mean, mass is the amount of the material present in an object. What amount of material present in a object, in an object, is called the mass. If I say that the mass of an phone, then how much quantity of material present in that phone is called the mass of that phone. And it is a quantity which doesn't depend upon the temperature, pressure, and the location. It is a constant quantity, and it is always remain constant. Okay, it never changes according to the temperature. Like if the temperature ranges from 10 degree to 20 degree, 30 degree, it doesn't affect the mass of a material. Similarly, location. If you say the location that you measure the mass here, and you take it to another city, then you again measure that mass, then you will not get any difference. Okay, so mass always remain constant. Even if you take it to the moon and measure the mass of that object, so it remain constant. It never change according to the location, position, pressure, temperature, etc. So now we will discuss what are the units, okay, available to measure the mass of an object, like kilogram, gram, quintal, then ton. These are some units, SI unit. Its SI unit is kilogram, okay, its SI unit is kilogram. But there are so different units as are also available to measure the mass, like I told you that gram, kilogram, okay, quintal, and ton. Quintal means it is the combination of 100 kilogram. If you combine, 100 kilogram, you can say it is 1 quintal. Similarly, 1000 kilogram means you can say it is 1 ton. Without saying, you need not to worry about to say that it is a big number like 1000 kilogram. Not say like that 1000 kilogram, simply say it is 1 ton. Similarly, don't say that it is 100 kg, simply say it is 1 quintal. If it is 200 kilogram, then say 2 quintal, so etc. So there are different units which are available to measure the mass of an object. So student, you know from which it comes, or who developed that unit. So it is basically developed or supplied by the International Bureau of Weight and Measurement Organization. It is a government organization which supply that unit, basically which we use nowadays. Then it is available in all countries. You can found it is available in all countries, and it is present in different laboratories. Okay, this system or this organization is present in different laboratory in different country. You can say that in our country it is also available, like in New Delhi it is available in the National Physical Laboratory, In our country, in the National Physical Laboratory, you can find the organization like International Bureau of Weight and Measurement or a BIPM, like Bureau of International Dashboard and Measure. Okay. So this organization supplied that unit, and it is this organization is the main part that supply the that unit which help us to measure the mass of a substance. Okay, look at the symbol. It is the symbol of the organization like BIPM or the International Bureau of Weight and Measurement. Okay, student, all this whatever I told you, it is it is basically used to measure that we see, like it is normal thing. It is used to measure the normal things, like if you want to measure up to 1000 kilogram, then if you want to measure a very small mass, then imagine how can you measure. Just imagine how can you measure. Is there any units available which help us to measure very small mass? Then I have a question. What do you mean by the very small mass? It is 1 gram, 2 gram? Not, student, it is not 1 gram, 2 gram. It is about the mass of an proton, electron, or the mass of an atom, molecule. It is the mass of very minute particle like this. So how can we measure the mass of these particles or subparticles? Okay. So to measure the mass of these particles, we have a different unit which we use for the measurement of the mass of this particle. It is called AMU, Atomic Mass Unit. Understand what Atomic Mass Unit? Atomic Mass Unit is used to measure a very small mass. I mean, it is basically used for the measurement of the mass of an atom, molecule. Now, I will show you how you calculate the value of 1 mu and what 1 mu means and how much kilogram is equal to 1 mu. So 1 mu is basically defined as the 1 by 12. Understand, 1 by 12 mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope. Understand, 1 mu is defined as the mass of 1/12 of the mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope, because carbon 12 isotope is a standard, the mass of a carbon 12 isotope is a standard value. That's why it is considered for its measurement, and it is equal to the 1.66 in 10 to the minus 27 kilogram. I think you can imagine how it is, how small it is, very very minute. You can imagine the mass is in the range of 10 to the minus 27 kilogram. So it is very 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 less. Okay, so simply 1.66 in 10 to the minus 27 kilogram, you can't say that this much of kilogram. You simply say one atomic mass unit. So one atomic mass unit is basically used to represent the atomic mass. Understand, atomic mass means the mass of an atom, molecule, or an element. Okay, so before we going to calculate that value, how the value like 1.6 in 10 to the 27 minus 27 kilogram comes. So before that, I want to say something that you have to know some basic terms like Avogadro's constant. So I hope you know and you are familiar with that name, like Avogadro's constant. It is in the class 10th and class 9th also it is there. So you know what is Avogadro's number. So Avogadro's number is a number and which we represent like Na. It is given by 6.022 into 10 to the 23 per mole. Okay. So what does it mean, Avogadro's constant? Means it represents the amount or the quantity amount of or the number of particles, I mean atoms, molecules, ions present in a sample. Understand? Avogadro's number means it represents the number of particles present in a sample, or you can say number of atoms present in an element, or number of ions, or number of molecules present in a sample. So now we'll calculate the mass of one particle, one atom of carbon 12 isotope. So carbon 12 means its mass is like 12 gram. So we can say 12 gram carbon 12 isotope contain 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms inside it. So we can say that is the 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms equal to 12 gram. So simply from that we can calculate the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. So it is equal to the, if you calculate, then mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope, it is given by 12 by that number, Avogadro's number. It is 12 by 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram. It is the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. But we need 1 by 12 of mass of one atom of the carbon 12 isotope. It is for 1 mu. So according to the definition of 1 mu, we will calculate the mass of, that is 1 by 12 mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope, simply divided by 12. So here you found that 1 mu equal to 1 by 12 into 12 by Na. 12 by Na, Avogadro's number, it is basically represent the mass of one atom of the carbon 12 isotope. But we need 1 by 12 mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope. That's why I divide again 12 here. Okay. So it gives like 1 by 12, 12 will cancel out. So it will give 1 by 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram. It is in gram. Okay. So if you calculate this, it will give you 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram, or you can say 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram. So basically this is the derivation how we will get 1 mu equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram. So now I will show you some measuring tools. Okay, but we will discuss what is mass and how, what is the units, how we will measure. So now we will discuss some tools which help you in the measuring system of the mass. So first, here it is like a valence. Okay, these are the constant unit, I hope you understand what do you mean by constant unit. It is a constant magnitude, okay, which helps us to measure an unknown quantity. Similarly, here nowadays we all are familiar with these tools, like it is a digital weight instrument which we use in our shop and day-to-day life. Similarly, these are the units which is used to measure the mass in the laboratory, like in the chemistry laboratory. When you go to the college and in your chemistry laboratory, you found that these types of units which you use in the measurement system, okay, mass measurement system. If you want to measure very small amount of salt or acid, okay, which you required, you can measure by using these type of units. Similarly, here I will represent some measuring tools. So there are so many different tools available in day-to-day life which we always interact with that. So one question is, I want to ask you one question, that we already know that how you measure very small mass, how you measure very, the mass of a normal things. But imagine, how can you measure very large mass, like the mass of a planet? If you want to measure the mass of an earth, how can you measure it? Is there any system? Okay, so how can you measure that? But we know mass of the earth is something, mass of the sun is something. So how can we got that? So for these measurement, this type of mass measurement, we also have a system which help us to measure the mass of very large things or very large mass. So this type of mass you can measure using the Newton's gravitational law. It is a basically law which help you to measure very large mass. Okay, so before going to the next, we just discuss what is Newton's gravitational law. But it is an extra chapter which is available in your syllabus, and we will discuss later the whole things, what is actually Newton's gravitational law. But I want to say a brief definition of that. Just remember, Newton's gravitational law means it is an attraction force, okay, between two heavenly body or between two things. We basically say it is the force of attraction between two heavenly body, and that force, the magnitude of that force is depend upon the mass of the two quantity, two planet. If you want to calculate the mass of an two planet, then you just apply the Newton's gravitational law. Newton's gravitational law represent the force of the attraction, okay, between the two heavenly body, and it is directly proportional to the multiplication of the masses of the given two body, and it is inversely proportional to the under root, square root of the distance, the separation distance between the two objects. So basically, by using this law, we can calculate, if you know the force between these two body, okay, and the separation of the distance between two body, then we can easily calculate the mass of different heavenly bodies. So it helps us to calculate very large mass. So finally, I want to discuss some masses, a range of masses of some things. The mass of the electron in the range of 10 to the minus 30, and similarly, proton have the mass in the order 10 to the minus 27, and the uranium atom, red blood cell in our body which present red blood cell, it also have some mass. So its magnitude is in the order of 10 to the minus 13. Raindrop, it is the mass of the raindrop is in the order of 10 to the minus 6. So there are various ranges of different things mass. So similarly, sun, the mass of the sun is in the range of 10 to the 30. Galaxy, which is 10 to the 41. So can you imagine that how much it is big? So to measure this type of mass, we can use the Newton's gravitational law. And here I show you mass or weight. Don't be confused about the on mass and weight. Mass is the amount of material present in an object, and which never change according to the due to the temperature, pressure, and location. But weight, don't be confused. Weight means it is just like it is a force which we calculate in the further class. Okay, weight always changes because force may change. Okay, it depend upon the position and the location. So different things are there in which the weight depends. So don't be confused on mass and weight. Weight is different thing and mass is different things. Okay, thank you students for watching this video. I hope you learn something from it. Thank you.